right in front of you. Sorry about that.
Morning. Thanks for coming.
Morning.
It's a lovely day today, isn't it?
Yeah.
God is good. Okay. So let's. We're gonna sing a song to start with, and this song is "How Great Thou Art." So I know this song since I was very young. So I remember I used to sing that with my grandpa. It's a lovely song. It's actually described how great is our God. This. And I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. Let's sing it together. Oh my God, when I was a wonder, consider all thy hands and have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power through our glorious display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. As I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and see the road and feel the gentle breeze, come sing my soul, my Savior God, to me.
Great now.
happy to be here in the square of our beautiful city to share a few words with you all this morning. I've got so much to say, but I've only got 5 minutes. Only got 5 minutes, so if you're passing by, please pause and linger, and maybe there's something for you. My name is Jack, and I'm part of this church. We're all from a church. It used to be called the Christchurch Chinese Church, but we changed the name to the Christchurch Community Church because churches are for everybody, right? The song that they just sang is, I think, one of the most well-loved gospel songs in New Zealand. And a few years ago, there was a very lovely man, a very wonderful man called Sir Morrison. What was his name? Sir Howard Morrison. And he used to sing this song. And he would sing it in Te Reo Māori. And he would say, whakarea mai. And when he would sing this song, it would put goosebumps on your arms, really. And it's a beautiful song, so thank you. But do you ever wonder, and do you ever think about the words, what they really mean? Oh Lord my God. Oh Lord my God. Is he your God? And you may say, well, I don't believe in God. Well, God believes in you. And you might say, well, I don't need God in my life. You know, I'm a tourist, I'm busy, I've got things to do. I don't need God in my life. But the truth is that everybody on this earth needs God. And I will tell you why. Because in the heart of every person on this earth, there is an emptiness. And everybody feels it. Everybody feels it. You probably feel it too. And the only thing that can ever fill this emptiness in your life is a relationship with God. There is nothing on this earth that can fill that emptiness. Only a relationship with God. And when I was a young boy, many years ago, I was a teenager, a friend came and he started talking to me about God. And I thought, I don't want to talk about God. I'm not interested in God. I don't need God in my life. But for some reason, I stopped. And I listened. I don't know why I stopped and listened, but I did. I could have said, I'm too busy. You know, I'm here in Christchurch. I'm here in the square. I've got places to go. I've got things to see. I've got food to sample. I've got things to buy. Don't talk to me about God. I'm too busy. But I didn't. I stopped. And I listened, and I believed. And God came into my life that day, and he changed me. And I've never been the same, and I never, ever regret it. This song says, when I think that God is Son not sparing, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, God the Father didn't hold on to his Son, he sent him down to this earth, Jesus. And of course, Jesus was happy to come. Why did Jesus come to this earth? To show us the way? Yes. To teach us how to be proper human beings? Yes. But he came for a greater reason. The song says, and when I think that God, his Son not sparing, sent him to die. That is the reason that Jesus came to this earth, to die. I scarce can take it in that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. He did. He bled and he died to take away my sin and your sin. And you may think, well, that was a long time ago. What's it got to do with me today? That was a long time ago. It was 2,000 years ago. What's it got to do with me today? Well, God is still working in this world today. And he knocks on the door of your heart. And he may be knocking on the door of your heart right now. Today, the 23rd of November, 2024, 11:15 a.m. Here in this country, this city, this cathedral square. You are here, you're passing by, I'm here. It's no accident. It's no accident. God loves you and he cares about you. And he knocks on the door of your heart and he says, let me come in. Let me come in and I'll fill the emptiness in your life. I'll change your life. I'll be your savior. I'll be your Lord. I'll be your strength. I'll be your joy. I'll be your solid foundation. I'll be your God. You can say, oh Lord, my God. If you want him, all you need to do is pray. Dear Jesus, I need you. Come into my life. Forgive my sins. Give me the gift of eternal life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. Be my strength. Help me. I need you, Lord. Amen. Simple prayer. And you can pray it today. So if you're passing by, why don't you come and take a seat? We've got some more songs for you. In a moment, we'll have some free food. And it might just change your life. Thank you.
Shalom, everyone. Shalom. So now we are going to worship our Lord with this song named 10,000 Reasons. And this song, the message is come from Psalm 103. It started with, bless the Lord, O my soul, worship his holy name. And this song speaks to the power of grace. We praise as a way to connect our God, and we finally find hope and peace in our life, especially in difficult times. So why don't we all stand, lift up our hearts, and worship him together.
on that day when my strength is failing. He can trust me and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise all that day. 10,000 years
Hi everyone, I am Grace, and I am glad to have this chance to share how I became a Christian. I was born and raised in China. My parents are not believers. They only wanted me to be well educated and knowledgeable. So I worked very hard to make them proud. I was the first of my dozens of cousins to get my university degree. And I even went to the US for my PhD. Everything I did was to please my parents. After finishing my PhD, my husband decided we should all move to Christchurch because he loved it here. So I gave up my career opportunities in both China and the US, moved here. That was 10 years ago. Christchurch was still recovering from the big earthquakes. There were hardly any people on the streets, and the shops closed at 5. I didn't know anyone, and I had nowhere to go. That was a turning point for me. It made me stop and think, what's the purpose of life? Was it just about getting paper qualifications and then encouraging my children to do so, and then my children's children? No, I couldn't accept that. There had to be more. So just to be clear, there is nothing wrong with working hard, pleasing our parents, or doing our best to make the world a better place. Thank you, Grace. Those are good things to do, but I realize the meaning of life can't just about what we see or what we do in this life. It has to go beyond that. Then I started going to church. The way people treated me, their loving attitude really touched me. And the sermons spoke about God's love I had never experienced before. I was so moved by his unconditional love and I couldn't wait to learn more. I was baptized the same year I moved here. I became hungry to know God, and that hunger kept me going to church regularly. Looking back, I am so glad I made the decision to receive Jesus as my Lord and my Savior. I found my purpose in Christ. My worth doesn't come from what I own or achieve, is measured by God's love only. Yes, we are all sinners, and we have sinned against God. But He can fix it. He offers forgiveness and hope for everyone who turns to Him. If you are seeking, if you are feeling empty or wondering about the purpose of your life, don't wait. Turn to God today. His love is real and the time is urgent. Thank you.
Morning, everyone. The next song we're going to sing to our Lord is called Goodness of God. In the lyrics, it says, all my life, God, you have been faithful, and all my life, you have been so, so good. Come, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed are those who take refuge in Him. Maybe when we sing and, you know, reflect during the song, we can think about, what shall I return to the Lord for all His goodness to us?
I love you, Lord. All my days have been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
大家早安。
Good morning, everyone.
我叫 Judy.
My name is Judy.
在26年前，我们全家移民到这里。
26 years ago, my whole family immigrated to New Zealand.
在当时，我对纽西兰知道的并不多。
At the time, I didn't know much about New Zealand.
只知道是个美丽的地方。
Only knew that it's a beautiful place.
如果当时有人从纽西兰来，然后带我走到纽西兰的话，那是不是就更清楚更好了呢？
So if someone from New Zealand took me for a guide for a tour, I'm in New Zealand, wouldn't that be much better?
圣经中告诉我们有个美好永存的家乡。
The Bible tells us there's a home that's our forever home.
有耶稣同在的天堂是为神的儿女而预备的。
This heaven that we can live with Jesus forever, this is prepared for sons, daughters, and God's sons and daughters.
更好的是，耶稣他答应我们，他会再来带我们到那里去。
The best thing is that Jesus has promised us that he will come again and he will bring us with him to there.
约翰福音十四章二节，在我父的家里有许多的住处。
In John 14, verse 2, it says, My father's house has many rooms.
若是没有，我早就告诉你们了。
If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm, would I have told you already?
我去是为你们预备地方。
That I'm going there to prepare a place for you.
我若去为你们预备了地方。我若去为你们预备了地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。你我在哪里，叫你们也在哪里。
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also be, may be where I am.
你们向往天堂吗？希望耶稣带我们去吗？
Does your heart desire for heaven? Do you want to go there as well?
邀请你来教会，更多认识这位爱我们的主。
I would like to invite you to come to church, to visit a church, and to know more about this God who loves us so much.
这位救我们出死入生的神。
This God who has died for us to save our life.
我觉得人生就像搭乘一辆火车。
I think our life is like taking a ride on a train.
从出生就开向死亡。
So the moment that you were born, you are driving towards death.
无论你是聪明、愚笨、有钱、没钱、美丽、丑陋、好人、坏人
，No matter you are rich or poor, let me get it. Sorry. Rich or poor, smart or stupid, beautiful or ugly, or you're a good person or a bad person.
我们都在这辆生命的列车上。
We are all on this train of life.
而且终点是地狱。
And we know that this destination is hell.
因为世人都犯了罪，
because,
而罪的代价就是死亡。
Because we have all sinned, and we know the price for sin is death.
结局已经命定。
This destiny is set for us.
火车自动导航，不可更改。
This train of life has got a GPS that we cannot change the course.
但创造宇宙万物的上帝，他是慈爱怜悯的。
But the God who created the universe, He is full of love and grace and mercy.
他不忍看见人灭亡。
He doesn't want to see us die.
在2000多年前，他差派他的爱子耶稣来到人世间。
2000 years ago, He sent His one and only Son, Jesus, to come to this earth.
开了一辆名叫重生的列车。
And He is also driven a train, but the train's name is salvation.
说凡信耶稣之名的不至灭亡反得永生。
So who believes, whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
这辆车的终点是天堂。
The destination of this new train is heaven.
好消息是愿意的人都可以上车。
The good news is whoever is willing can get on this train.
免费。
And it's free of charge.
因为耶稣已经为我们付清了永生的代价。
Because Jesus has paid the price for us.
他的宝血在十字架上流出，洗净世人的罪。
On the cross, he bled for us and to wash away our sins.
更好的是，他应许我们永远不离弃我们，永远与我们同在。
And the best part is he has promised us that he will never forsake us or leave us.
因此在这里邀请 你还没有上这永生列车的旅客，赶快上车。So
I would like to invite everyone who has not boarded this train yet to come with us.
看清人生的终点站,
to discern, you know, which destination of life that you want to head to.
要转车喽。
It's time to get on the transfer station.
也不要赶不上喽。
And don't wait too long because you might miss this train.
已经上车的旅客, 你也不要倒头就睡。
And the person with the passengers who has already bought the train of eternal life, don't just fall asleep.
失去与主陪伴过高山低谷的经历,
and miss all the experiences that God walk with you through mountain and valley.
你也不要一直低头看手机,
and don't just stare on your phone.
失去了与同行旅客 彼此陪伴鼓励的机会哦,
and miss the opportunity to talk to your companion on this beautiful train.
因为我们也不知道什么时候就要下车了,
because we don't know when this train will reach the destination.
约翰福音3章16节,
in book, John 3:16 says,
神爱世人, 甚至将他的独生子赐给他们, 叫一切信他的人不至灭亡,
for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
这就是神给我们的福音,
this is the gospel, the good news that God gave us. I wish that we could all become God's sons and daughters and have our sins forgiven, and to receive the promise from God, the eternal life. In this life, that we can walk with God and have his peace and joy filled with us. May God bless everybody.
谢谢.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Martha. The next song we're going to sing is called God is Good All the Time. I can see that some of you are Christians out there that I know already. And if you can affirm to that, could you say that with me?
God is good all the time.
And all the time, God is good.
And all the time, God is good.
I love this song because I have experienced this to be true in my life. God is good in the wonderful times and in the difficult or the scary or the sad times. God has always been there. He never has left me. And he's poured out his blessings, and through everything, even in the sad times, he still gives me a joy in my heart and puts a song of praise in my heart. So let's together praise the Lord for his goodness all the time.
God is good, God is good all
is a good God, isn't he? Bless the Lord.
Good morning, I'm Ada. I've been here in Christchurch for 12 years. It's good to see all of you today. And before I believe in God and experience God's love, I had barriers to get along with others. I had very low self-esteem, was self-protective, and did not know how to care for others or understand their feelings. When it's probably because when I was 1.5 years old, my mother ran away from home and I lived with my elderly grandparents. My grandparents' family is very poor. I'm not only the youngest, but also the most humble in the big family. I'm a burden and a punching bag to my relatives as well. Growing up in such a lack of care and poverty caused me to have very low self-esteem and find it difficult to get along with others. And I don't know how to get along with my father as well. And he become a stranger to me, although actually we supposed to be the closest in our relationship. So in junior school, I leave my grandparents' house and start living with my father and my stepmothers for several years. Because I was always beaten and scolded and starved, my father turned from a stranger to me into a person I hate. I left home at a very young age and lived alone and alienated myself from all other people around me. And thanks God that I have been exposed to God, to the faith, since I was a child in a Christian school. Later, my grandparents, they believed in God and asked me to come home and live with them. It was the first time for me to experience the love of a family and witness how God changes my grandparents' life. I started to go to church with my grandparents to know more about God. And after years, all I found is God loves me so much. He filled my heart with His word in Bible and respond my prayers faithfully. He treated me completely different, opposite to how my father treated me. He comforts me when I'm worried and sorrowed. He forgives me when I screw up, I make mistake. He is patient to me when I try to roll back to the old me, the one who tried to alienate myself from other people, but He patiently lead me back with His open arms. He's faithful and He's trustworthy. After experiencing God's love for me, I have become full of care and enthusiastic for the people around me. That's why you see me now today. With my self-esteem restored by God, I'm willing to open my heart and establish friendly relationships with others. Now, God repaid me with a loving family, for I trusted in God, in Him. But not long after, God changed me in His love. I've really let go of my hatred for my father and even started to pray for my father's salvation. So long after that, my father, whom I been lost contact for many years, suddenly called me to tell me that he had a lung disease. And then I was both worried for his health and also sad when all my bad memories with him attacked me at the same time. I asked the church to pray for me. I asked God to give me strength as he always does. And God, again, he's faithful. He answered my prayer. God sent my two elder sisters who were willing to put down her sorrow and resentment and helped me to take care of my father in the hospital together. In the hospital, I told my father, I forgive you, and do you want God to forgive you too? And it was the first time I saw him cry, and he said yes, and he received the forgiveness from God. And my father passed away after 3 months, after the onset of the lung cancer. And I was sad, but I thank God I had no regrets. because I know now that even I were to die and leave this world tonight, I will be sure I will go to heaven. I will give my Father in the heaven a hug. Thank you.
Okay, so now we're gonna, so we do actually pick one Chinese song, and this song is, this is the day that the Lord has made. So in the lyric says that, Lord, you are my strength, you are my shelter. And it's a happy song. Let's sing together. If you know the song, let's sing together and hope you enjoy it. This is the day the Lord has made.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Vivian. I would like to share my testimony with my God's encounter. About 17 years ago, I was sponsored to do my PhD study related to artificial intelligence in New Zealand. At that time, I had a good career and good family with two young children. However, I always felt insecure in my heart, feeling always lack of something. One day, when doing my research, I came across an online video series explaining the Bible and the science. The speaker was a scientist in genetic research. She explained that when they did experiments to breed the bacteria, after thousands of generations, the bacteria is still a bacteria. It won't evolve to other creatures or human. As a human, so there's a God of the universe to create a human. And he felt he left the Bible as a human's manual to guide us in our life. In the Bible, it says that fearing the God is the beginning of wisdom. Knowing the Holy One is clever. That touched my heart. I was thinking if I build a robot, when the robot has a problem, it will sure need to come back to me at its creator. As a human, I always felt something is missing and also encountered some situations that I could not handle by myself in my life. Why not I try to accept this God of the universe? For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, Jesus Christ, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. So I repent and accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior. I wanted to go back to search the answer of my life from my Creator. Once I built up my relationship with God, I felt peace in my heart, and I'm confident even though I face difficulties in my life. When I pray to God, He guide me and blessed me in many ways. I can feel His love and found the purpose as a human living in this world. I hope you all can also recognize your Creator. Let His love surround you and bless you. May God bless you every day. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, it's towards the end now, so we're going to finish up with the national anthems. So we will have the little girl, Raylan, to sing in Maori, and then after that we sing in English, okay? Shall we all stand up? And,
No.
You can be seated. Thank you, everybody. I don't know how you feel when you hear this song. I feel great joy and I feel great sadness. You know, this was a country that used to be a Christian country. But so many people have turned away from God in this country. This was a very beautiful country, and it's very touching to me to see a group of immigrants, people who were not born in this country, but have come to live in this country, who love this country, who love New Zealand, and sing the national anthem with pride and joy. And it's a sad thing to me that the last maybe 60 years, people have been trying to get God out of our country. They even want to get rid of this song. They say that it's an old song, it's a boring song, it's a dirge. We don't like that song, let's get rid of that song. Let's have something more alive and more modern and more new. They want to get rid of God. People have been chopping at the roots of our country for 60 years. Chopping away, getting rid of God. And what happens when you chop at the roots? What happens if you chop the roots? Fruit falls off. All the good things go. What do you end up with? You end up with a violent country, crime-ridden, divided country, angry country. That's what we've got. I stand here, I look at that building over there. To me, it's a symbol of what's happened in our country. A broken church in the center of our city. I want to tell you that the church in this country is not actually broken. Parts of it are, but parts of it are very alive. We just thank God that God has brought many new people to our country. Chinese, Koreans, Indians, Filipinos. And over the summer months here, you will see different churches standing up here. Ours is a Chinese church. After I stop talking, the Indian brothers over here are going to take over from an Indian church. After there will be a Samoan church, brother over here, his church of Samoans. And then there'll be Filipinos and Africans who will be here in the square. So there are parts of the church in our country that are thriving and flourishing. It's just a shame that us white people, we've turned away from our God. So thank you for coming this morning. Thank you for singing so well for us. Samuel and Victoria, who run these programs from Shekinah Trust, they are going to cook some chicken sausages soon. So hang around and you'll get a free sausage. And hang around and enjoy the Indian brothers. So let's invite them over and let's give them a hand. Thank you.
How's everyone doing? Good. We are from Calvary Assembly of God Church, and we are located at Blenheim Road. The precise address is 50 Akron Drive. So where we see a warehouse on the Blenheim Road, we are just in that car park behind the SPCA. So if you guys are around that way, just come. We'll all worship together, right? And yeah, we had a great song so far. We're going to also sing some songs. We're going to... I want everyone to stand up for the first song. The first song, we're going to sing, Great is Your Faithfulness, Your God. So while we're singing this song, let's all clap and let's join us with us. Let's sing it, brother. We
Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, O God. Your grace is enough, your grace.
Great is your love and justice, God. Everyone say,
great is your love and justice, God. You use the weak to lead the strong.
You lead us.
You lead us in the song of your salvation.
All your people.
And all your people sing along.
Everyone say, remember.
So remember your people. Remember your children. Remember your promise, O God. Your grace is enough. Your
let's all clap. Amen. May be seated. I just want to share a small testimony. In next 4 days, it'll be for me 8 years in New Zealand. And last 8 years, I just wanted to see the goodness of God in my life. I just want to share that lot of places, ups and downs, and everywhere God was with me, you know. And yes, I'm a human, we're all human, we are going through things to settle down here, to call this as our hometown. There are a lot of things we need to go through as well. In that, I'm also part of it. Sometimes the rules are not favorable for us, sometimes the situations are not favorable for us, but one thing is always favor on our side is our God. That's why today we are here. I am here testifying in the center of the city that the God's goodness last 8 years was so great. Thus the song said, His grace is always enough for me. And it's always enough for us as well. So I just want everyone to get encouraged about it. And no matter what we go through, God's grace is enough. That's why today we are going to stand here. We're going to start screaming at. We're going to start dancing. The next song it says, I want to scream it out from every mountaintop because His goodness is no bound, right? And I sing because you're good. I dance because you're good. And I shout because you're good. Do you all agree God is good?
Amen.
We just sang that song, right? God is good. That's why we are going to sing because He is good. So let's sing the next song, brother. Amen.
God, He is good to us. Yesterday I wanted to go to the mountains and scream it out, but I can't do that. I wanted to make use of this time to share the testimony that God has blessed me with. I was born in the country called India. I never had a plan of moving to New Zealand, but God has showed me to this man as my husband, And I have to move here. Before I moved here, I was a bit nervous as to how people will take me because they are all strangers here. But after moving here, God has blessed me with a lot of people here who treat us like a family, who teaches us, who helps us, who guides us, who wants to protect us. So I'm so blessed to be here in this city called Christchurch, which is named after the God himself. Amen. So I want to thank God for all his blessings. He has blessed me. After coming here, he has blessed me with a job, with everything that we prayed for. But before meeting him, my plan is different, but God's plan towards me was different. It's all about how we take God's plan into our lives, how we apply it on our lives. So I wanted to conclude my testimony with just a word. Just accept God's plan. God's plans are different from our plans. As part of my plan, I might have stayed in India with a group of people I know. But I am so grateful that I'm worshiping God in the midst of all of you. And I'm thankful to God, even after moving from India to here, God is using us in his ministry and helping our church and the pastor and whatnot. I want to thank God for everything. Amen.
God has done so many miracles, right? And the next song we are singing says, our God is greater and our God is stronger. Do you all agree? I hear a lot of response. That's why I'm asking, do you all agree? Because our God is greater. We're going to sing that song because it says, into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise, because there is no one like him. No one like him. And that's why we're going to sing, our God is greater. So let's proclaim that word as you respond to me. Thank you, brother.
Then what can stand again?
Our God is greater.
our God is strong, God. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God. Our God.
One last everyone.
Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power, our God.
To tell everyone how much our God loves us. I was really, really broken and really, really down. When I mean broken, really broken. I used to cry and cry and cry and did not want to leave. But God lifted me up, and He's an awesome God. And when He lifted me up, there was never looking back. And He blessed my family, also abandoned me. And God blessed me with a loving husband and a brand new family. And I thank God for that. He's an awesome God. He does miracles so great. And when Jesus says yes, nobody can say no. So if He can do it for me, He can do it for you guys as well. So I encourage everyone to have faith and keep praying. Amen.
Yes. Our God, He can move mountains, right? That's why we call Him Savior. And we're going to sing this next song. It says, Savior, He can move the mountains. And my God is mighty to save, right? So we all know this song. Let's take these words and let's actually mean that words while we're singing to our God. And whatever, if we are going through anything, we need to believe that today that He can move mountains. So let's sing that. Thank you, brother.
My God is mine.
God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave.
Yes. Savior, He can move the mountains. Hello everyone, how are you doing? Are good? My name is Aaron. This guy's done a good job, eh? Let's give them a hand. Yes. Your first time singing and praising God in the middle of Christchurch, so well done. And we are here just to share the love of God. We've got lives, we've got jobs, we've got families, everything busy like everyone else. But we have taken this opportunity to say that we believe in someone. We believe in someone who can make a difference in our lives. As He has made a difference in our life, He can make a difference in everyone's life. How many people believe that? Yes, we believe that, and that's why we are here. We are here not to just fill in the gap, but we are here to proclaim the name which is above all other names. We are here to say that, yes, Jesus works. We are here to say that, yes, we believe in Jesus. And if you just call on Him, He will answer you. I love this story in the Bible where there's a blind man who called on Jesus. All he did was just call on Jesus. And that's all we have to do today. Jesus, help me. Whoever you are, whoever you are, we have sang a few songs. His grace is enough, right? What does that mean? It means that one person has gone to the cross and believed and received Jesus, but there's room for so many more. Amen? There's room for so many more. His grace will never run out. It's like a fountain. It will keep overflowing. Whoever comes to Jesus, whoever calls on Him, He's there for them. And so we are here today, and we might sing one more song, Your Grace is Enough, one more time. And if you believe in Jesus, let's stand up and let's sing and let's believe that the God who made a difference in our life, He can make a difference in our city. Amen. And whoever needs Jesus, if they call on Jesus, He can make a difference in their lives too. Thank you, guys.
You use the weak to make them strong.
Let's give God a hand. Yes, His grace is enough. I just want to thank all of you for joining us. Thank you for the Shekinah Trust for holding this event. And there's a few more summer series, few more meetings will be here. There's some food, there's some chicken sausages there for all of us. So please have one. And we just want to thank God for this wonderful opportunity. God bless you all.